and it was kind of like, it just didn't feel right.
Big went on the road with the Junior Mafia and Little Kim.
My first impression of Kim was she was cool. I really thought she was cool. She was fun.
Big kind of encouraged me to befriend her, you know? It was like, okay, that's his artist. I didn't have a problem with that at all.
He used to be like, oh, take Kim to the gym or take Kim shopping with you or, you know, whatever.
I remember even a time when Big was staying at a hotel and Kim was there. But I didn't think anything of it. I remember her going on the radio saying, like, something about me and Big and there's no rings. And it was just weird to me why she would be speaking on me and our marriage.
Kim was talking about Big in a way that could have been construed as a romantic relationship.
Only me and him could always know what that relationship was like.
It was enough to tell something was going on. I don't know, something just told me to go to his townhouse in TNA. It was all dark. And I just started touching around, right, you know? And I felt somebody right there. And he turns on the light, and it was Little Kim. I just started hitting it, hitting. And then she left. When I left a couple hours later, I had a Land Cruiser, and it was, like, scratched from, like, every single inch of the surface of the car was scratched up. Like, she got busy. Oh, my God.
Faith was really hurt because she saw Kim as her little sister.
And I just kind of felt, like, really stupid. Because I'm like, wait, all this time I've been, you know, like, really? And you told me to be around her? So I just was very, like, I don't think we're going to be together anymore.
No, they were just younger. He was just slipping up at times, you know, just getting caught up and just, you know, doing stupid. And it messed up their marriage.
I was very humiliated at her. But what I'm not going to do is let my feelings right now affect the fact that I have to have stability for my daughter. I still got my own thing over here.
China actually gave me a motivation to figure something out.
Faith called me telling me that she had to move and that she was going to leave Big. And I'm like, where are you going to move to, Faith? Where are you and China going to move? She was like, I don't know. I just have to get out of this apartment. I just left. I was kind of done. When her and Big started separating, she felt strange being around any bad boy family events. I was working, but I'm not as much, you know. I think, and that may have been even on purpose. I was kind of ducking him.
Faith wanted independence from Bad Boy Records and Biggie and started looking for work outside of it.
While I was in Los Angeles, I was working on a new project with these girls, and one night we decided to go out to a club, and that was when I met Tupac at Hollywood Athletic Club. Big had always spoken very highly of Tupac. He really considered him like his homeboy.
But Faith was unaware that Tupac held ill feelings towards Biggie for the Quad Studio incident.
When Tupac came out to Quad Studios, there were guys waiting for him. Upstairs, Biggie, and all these guys were there. He ended up getting shot.
Rap artist Tupac Shakur was apparently attacked in a New York City recording studio.
Right when it happened, Big called me. Scared sounding to me, to be quite honest. So he told me he was going to go to Bellevue and make sure he was okay.
From Tupac's perspective, he said nobody would look him in the eye, and that people that were upstairs must have known that he was going to be ambushed and robbed.
Big didn't want no drama. Big didn't dislike Tupac. He just felt like, okay, like, dude, like, bugging out.
Before the shooting, they were very friendly and brotherly.
Peace and love. Here you go.
So when Tupac met Faith, he saw a chance to get back at Biggie through her.
They came and they were like, hey, Faith, how you doing? Yo, Tupac wants to meet you. No big deal. I didn't feel like I shouldn't meet him. The photographer wanted to snap pictures. Hey, you guys take a picture. You know, I want to get a picture of you guys.
Tupac told me he was a big fan and that he'd heard my music and that he would love to do a record with me one day. I was like, oh, okay, that's really dope. Let me know. So we exchanged information.
Faith wanted to provide for her daughter and wasn't thinking about anything else.
Tupac and I negotiated me getting $25,000 for writing and singing the hook. And at that time, I needed the $25,000. When I called Big to tell him that Pop asked me to be on his record, he didn't tell me not to do it either. As long as the money was straight and the business was straight, then it didn't seem like something I shouldn't do. We get to the studio, and I basically think I'm just coming to do a hook, which usually doesn't take me very long. And I went in the booth, and the song was
did the song, did the session for a couple of hours. It wasn't that long, and that was it.
He told me that his manager was going to bring the check to his room. We could drive to the hotel.
I can go. We can go
get it. Especially in this situation. I definitely got to get my money. When we get into his room, his friends, they all, you know, kicking it and having drinks and smoking. And, you know, I just kind of felt it becoming a little menacing in a way. And then he said that I needed to suck his to get my money. And I, you know, I was shocked. I was a little scared. But I think I kind of started crying a little bit, like, you know, being somewhat humiliated that he would even think that that's how it is.
Song hit them up. Tupac mocks Ɓiggie and claims that he slept with his wife.
The media was writing all about it.
What's the situation with your Tupac, the LA situation? What's going on?
Why was I the poster child for the beef? Like, what? How? What is really going on? I just knew I needed to get back home, talk to Big, and try to explain to him what really happened.
I mean, we were going through problems, but
while the media claimed that Tupac had stolen fame, Biggie took out his anger on her.
He grabbed up in a chokehold, bro. I think it's because of the feelings about her.
Biggie was torn, but he couldn't let go of fame yet.
When he called me to come see him in New Orleans, you know, he just kind of appealed to me as if he really wanted to see me. He really wanted to spend some time with me. And you know, I went down there. I know for a fact that's when I got pregnant. When I told Big that I found that I was pregnant, he was sounding surprised, like, you sure? I was like, yeah, I'm sure.
When Biggie's song, Brooklyn's Finest, came out, media rumors started to spiral that Faith was pregnant with Tupac's baby.
Biggie's song lyric says that if Faith is having twins, she is having Tupac's.
Very, very shocked. Her, I didn't even speak to him. I was so mad at him.
The media claimed that East Coast and West Coast were fighting because of